Hello there, I'm Suma from Malaysia. I'm a member of the Sathya Sai Academy here, and I've done my advanced diploma in education and human values. I'm working as a visiting professor for the American University of Sovereign Nations. So I'm currently doing for Wawasan Open University in Malaysia. I'm also a tutor there. So what I'm trying to do, my work is mostly to integrate values and ethics into the current subjects that the core subjects in schools, as well as in STEM education. These are the two core areas that I'm working with. Looking at post-COVID or even the ongoing COVID situation, we know that many education systems are having issues, especially with online. And one of the main reasons, I think, is it's education is business driven. So having now looking at an integrated approach to planetary health, this includes environment, education, health education, and humanity with spiritual human values and ethics. So this is exactly what I'm targeting. And I'm looking at a curriculum which has been tested in many countries. I will talk about it in the later section. Now, UNESCO has said learning to know, learning to do, learning to live together, and learning to be are the four pillars of education. But looking at the last UNESCO's last option, that is learning to be, seems to be very difficult because learning it talks about learning to live together. And this is that is why I think education and human values is very important. Arina Bokova from UNESCO, she said, we need education to disarm the fears that many feel of the unknown and of other people, their cultures, life choices, and beliefs. Education is the best way to foster a culture of peace and build inclusive societies. So as a values educator, I believe there is immense potential if educators move from teaching subjects to teaching students. The peer team, this whole project actually originated from India, from Prashanthi Nilaya. And this particular institution is standing out as a crest jewel in the university education system in the country. And this model is worthy of emulation because it was also looked at by the National Assessment and Accreditation Council, University Grants Commission India. We are looking at the pedagogical approach, which includes silent visualization techniques for schools that connects the neurosciences, knowledge and increased awareness, storytelling, music, group activities, which are experiential learning-based lessons, community service and sealing of desires program, both for environment and health, which has become very important today for all schools and globally. Now, connecting education for secondary school and universities, integrating neuroscience, psychology, philosophy, and sociology. I'm currently experimenting it with STEM education, and we are using David Kolb's model. And Kolb's learning cycle is taken into the learning system itself. And as you see, that Kolb's learning cycle includes four different areas. One is concrete experience, reflective observation, abstract conceptualization, and active experimentation. I think this is going to be very important, especially when we are bringing in artificial intelligence and big data, because this is where I think bioethics and ethics will play a very big role. Especially in bioethics, the critical thinking, reflection, and discrimination components, I think they are very important to integrate into the subjects. Now, has education become a business now? Looking at Sternberg's work, he talks a lot about tacit knowledge, and tacit knowledge gives a lot of fundamental discrimination and social discrimination and individual discrimination, which leads to critical thinking. Now, social discrimination, I think there are lots of queries about sustainable development and they are unresolved. And there's a lot of speculation on how ethics can be integrated into all these subjects. So in my OER and the collective OER, which I dream of that will work, we'll have ethics, which ethics as well as the philosophy from Aristotle's Nicomachean Ethics, so from a social cognitive perspective, as well as Daryl Mace's bioethics, as he calls it, the love of life, because education is not, I think it has to be very holistic. Now, from schools, at the school level, we teach individual discrimination, what is good for me and for my society. And that is where human values and ethical conduct will play a very big role. And students will be able to meet challenges in the future. So this includes experiential knowledge as well as socio-cognitive knowledge. Meeting challenges and driving inner resources and potential. Looking at human values, they are derived from everyone's inner resources. And hence, I take this particular concept from Dahl and Tessin. Spirituality is about applying the principles of being mindful of who you are and what you need to do to overcome and address a particular issue. We can choose to live in joy or live in misery. We can tell ourselves, I don't want to be negative about this. Now, this is what we want our children to be like in the future. Education now inquires about nature. Nanotechnology, genomic studies, STEM education, robotic technology, and biotechnology. Now, what's missing is EduCare, which transforms through us inquiring about our own nature. What is it that we want? Do we need planetary health? Do we need a sustainable education for all? Or is it for the elite? So this is what we need to question now at this crucial moment, especially during this COVID-19. Jumsai, Human Values Integrated Instructional Model that I spoke about is from Thailand. And it has been applied in Thailand, Malaysia, America in one or two schools, the UK, Africa, and UN Habitat for Water Education has adopted this particular model. And I've tested the model and it is in the report. This is the model by Dr. Jumsai. Now, he's from Chulalongkorn University. And this particular model has been implemented in a school where every aspect of student learning is incorporated with values education and is community driven. And what I experienced there was wonderful because this particular model being taken anywhere can work. And we have it in Malaysia as well. It has worked well for us. And this is the particular study that I did with Indonesia, Philippines, and Indonesia, Thailand, and Laos. And I presented at Sweden on water education. Now, we know water is a global topic now because there is a lot of speculation about water, having enough water by 2030, if I'm not mistaken. And that's what UNESCO has declared, that we are going to have water shortage. And we implemented this particular program in Thailand in cooperation with UN Habitat. And we found that teachers did have very good transformation. And I had surveyed them as well as done in-depth interview. And this was presented in Sweden. With STEM education, I know it's a hot topic in America as well as here in Asia.
Suma, I just wanted to let you know, you have about 30 seconds left.
Okay. So we did a workshop conduct, which actually helped all these teachers and policymakers. So I just like to share that as well. I will just move on with my slides. This here's an example from the USA. Teachers comments, the effect is unity. It pulls us together like a family. I'm more aware of being a positive role model because of these lessons. I'm learning with it as much as the children. These ideas will take them through life. Something wakes up inside. Now, I'm going back to, this is another evaluation report, and this is a reflection on how values education worked in both Asia and Africa. The assessment procedures are also there. We use Bloom's taxonomy to assess the various levels of transformation and educational assessment for cognitive and psychomotor skills for secondary schools, especially, and at university level. This is the OER model that I've done, and it's now in the Advanced Corporate Journal at New York. And this is talking about interns in corporates as well as companies. I've just updated the from the earlier version. I'm now focusing on interns and experiential learning, on health, education, and environment, all with integrated with ethics. Yeah. So now there's a book that is coming up on human values, developing the child of the future, human values pathway for teachers. I'm inviting everyone to give us a chance to integrate this with subjects with the OER system. Thank you very much.